everyone, welcome to the very first video of Jolly Phonics Masterclass 101. Now this masterclass is for all those parents who are interested in teaching their young kids to read and write fluently. And it is for all those educators who want to introduce Jolly Phonics curriculum into their classrooms. Now this masterclass is going to be a series of videos where you will learn the step-by-step process of introducing Jolly Phonics curriculum to your young children. In these videos, I'll be taking each topic of Jolly Phonics in detail and I will try to make you understand the concepts of Jolly Phonics and how to introduce it to your young children to get the maximum benefits out of it. So today's video is going to be about every single thing that you need to know and understand before starting Jolly Phonics. So I want you to grab your pen and paper and start taking the notes. Please watch the video carefully through the end, and if you have any questions regarding the concepts, please make sure you mention it down in the comments so I can take it up in future videos. Let's start from the basics. What exactly is Jolly Phonics? Jolly Phonics is a comprehensive program based on research. It is a fun and multi-sensory synthetic phonics method that gets children reading and writing fluently from an early age. It is aimed at teaching the alphabetic code to the young kids in a simple yet structural manner. In Jolly Phonics, each letter sound is introduced through a story and action to reinforce the learning process. Now, before we start with the concepts of Jolly Phonics, let's first discuss some frequently asked questions about Jolly Phonics. I'm sure it is going to help us clear a lot of doubts and misunderstandings. The first frequently asked question is, why do we need Jolly Phonics? This is one of the most common questions most parents have. We all have learned English without phonics and still we are pretty good at reading and writing, isn't it? Now to get the answers, let's compare the traditional, or what it's frequently called is the whole word method, and Jolly Phonics. In whole word method, the child is supposed to memorize all the words by sight. That means for them, 100% of the words are sight words. No logic, no structure or code is taught here. Only the children with excellent visual memory are successful in reading and writing fluently, but rest of the children struggles. And the result is semi-fluent readers. While in Jolly Phonics, children are taught to decode the words with the knowledge of letter sounds. Hence, in Jolly Phonics, around 70% of the words are easily decodable, while only 30% needs to be memorized. Now you can understand which method is easy, fast, and structured. Honestly, I'm not sure when I was 5 years old, I was equally fluent reader as my phonetically trained child currently is. The next question is, when should I start Jolly Phonics? So the ideal age to start Jolly Phonics is 3 years. At this stage, letter sounds from the group 1 to 3 are introduced to the child in sequential manner. Before this, we can work on the phonological awareness of the child. That is, we can work with our child in understanding the sounds around us. We can do this by asking questions about the sounds our child can hear in a park or in a zoo, or simply by reinforcing the letter sounds while reading aloud to the child. Another frequently asked question is that I am using Jolly Phonics for my kid, but I'm not getting the desired results. So here, it is our responsibility to get complete knowledge about the Jolly Phonics program before we introduce it to our kids. Also, we can take help from the trained teachers. mixing 2-3 phonics curriculum is only going to create a lot of confusion into the child's mind, and it will do more harm than good. Also, practice is the most important part of the whole learning process. Give your child enough time to practice the concepts and master it before moving forward to the next one. Another frequently asked question is that my child is phonetically trained and he can read also, but he's weak in comprehension. Here, we need to be aware of the goals and achievables with any program that we follow. Jolly Phonics aims at teaching children letter sounds and rules to help them read and write fluently and correctly. However, comprehension is the understanding of the text that we are reading. Jolly Phonics may set the base, but the comprehension can only be achieved with lots and lots of reading practice and discussions about the text that we are reading. Take for example, how many of us can actually read an astrophysics book? Most of us, right? But how many can understand the text? Very few, because we do not have the knowledge about it or the terminology that has been used in the book. Similarly, with Jolly Phonics, a child can decode the word and read it also, but the meaning of the word and the context into a text can only be understood with the practice of reading. Now let's understand the structure and process of Jolly Phonics. Let's see what is to be taught and how it is to be taught. The Jolly Phonics program has 5 principal segments: learning the letter sounds, learning the letter formations, blending, segmenting, tricky words, and once all these are done, we introduce alternate vowel sounds. Though these are different skills, but most of these are taught simultaneously. Now let's understand each of these sections separately. Learning the letter sounds. Jolly Phonics starts with teaching letter sounds to the children. There are 42 plus letter sounds represented by 26 letters. All these letters or sounds are grouped into 7 segments. Each letter sound is introduced with a story and an action. This makes children use all of their senses while learning the letter sound. For example, while introducing the sounds, the suggested storyline is: a boy takes his dog for a walk. He hears the dog barking, and then sees a snake rear up hissing, and the children are expected to make a hissing sound along with a movement of hand making a snake shape. In Jolly Phonics, the letter sounds are divided into 7 groups of 6 letter sounds each. Once all the 7 groups are completed, the 8th one, which is alternate vowel sounds, are introduced to the children. Now, if you are wondering why there is a specific set of letter sounds into one group, then there is a research and reason behind it. Now, if you check this example, here we have taken a group of letters. In the first segment, there are a simple A to F, while in the other one it is the group 1 letter sounds of Jolly Phonics. Now the number of letters that can be made from the first 6 letters of alphabet is very less as compared to those from the first group 1 letter sounds of Jolly Phonics. We can make over 40 words from just the 6 letter sounds of group 1 letters. This means that the children can make more than 40 words just by learning the group 1 letter sounds of Jolly Phonics. The next section in Jolly Phonics is learning the letter formation. Letter formation is being taught simultaneously to the letter sounds. Letter formation can be taught by working on a worksheet, or just by simply air writing. It is majorly intended to understand the hold of pencil and correct strokes to form the letters. The next section is blending of sounds. Blending is the process of mixing two or more sounds together to form words. It is the basic foundation of reading process and also known as synthesizing. While introducing blending, children should be able to identify sounds in a particular word. For example, if we are working with the letter S, the child should be able to identify the sound S in the words like sand, sun, soil. And the fun part is, you don't even need to wait to complete all groups of letter sounds to start blending. You can start blending once the child has mastered the first three letter sounds of group 1. Meaning, the child can start reading within 1 month of starting the Jolly Phonics program. The next section is segmenting. Segmenting is when a child can hear each and every sound in a word and know how to represent those sounds with their corresponding letters. Perfect segmenting skill helps children write hundreds of words with correct spelling all by themselves. To master the skill of segmenting, it is so important that the child is able to identify and hear the sounds in a word. For example, when we hear the word blend, we can hear five sounds here. That is b, l, e, n, d. However, when I say the word speech, I am able to identify just four sounds here, that is speech, speech. In the coming videos, when I'll be taking segmenting as an individual subject, I will share the games, activities and different approaches that we can use to help the children master the skill of segmenting. Now this brings us to the last section of Jolly Phonics, and that is tricky words. Tricky words are irregular words, words that do not completely follow the phonics rules. A part of tricky word is always regular, but still, the children are expected to memorize these words and read them at sight. In Jolly Phonics, we introduce children to 72 tricky words divided into 12 groups. These are the most frequently used words. There are many fun ways through which tricky words can be introduced to the children to ensure maximum retention. We will see these activities in our coming videos. Now this covers the complete structure of Jolly Phonics. The alternate vowel sounds and the rules of Jolly Phonics are introduced at the later stages, which we will cover in our upcoming video sessions. I truly hope that you guys now understand the structures and concept of Jolly Phonics. In the next video, I'll be taking up the group 1 of letter sounds, and I'll let you know how to introduce them to your child with the help of games and activities. So please make sure to subscribe to our channel so that you do not miss any of the updates. And if you like this video, do like it and share it with your friends and family who will benefit from it. Till the next video, bye-bye, take care and happy learning.